Peggy 16.
The improvisation engine is a series of interwoven systems that ensure that the game has plenty of variety and challenge for the player.
When we're developing a quest, for example, in Underworld Ascendant, we don't have a specific idea in mind of what actions the player is going to take to overcome those challenges, to meet the goals of the quest. It's really just about putting the player in an environment, in a situation with some goals, and with a variety of tools. And it's up to them to find the solution.
You have these systems in the game that interact with each other. So imagine an engine running and it has spinning gears, and you throw a monkey wrench into it. And that monkey wrench is going to mess up this gear, and it's going to cause a chain reaction from gear two all the way up to gear four. So basically, it's systems that are doing things, and you are the one messing with the systems that are running regardless of you being there or not.
What we are doing with Underworld Ascendant incorporates some of what we like best about our favorite computer role-playing games, but also tries to incorporate some of the feel that we get out of tabletop gaming that we don't necessarily see in all video games. And that, for us, has a lot to do with, again, the freedom of choice that you have in a tabletop setting, the improvisational, inventive feel of gameplay, right? Where you just have a game master who's presenting situations to the players, right? And whatever solution you can come up with in the context of the tools available to you is there for you to pursue.
Underworld Ascendant is very heavily about player choice in many different ways. One of the first examples that we gave is a door. A door presents challenges and opportunities. A locked wooden door can be burned down with a spell, with a torch, with some debris. It can be lockpicked silently. It can be broken down, but the sound that occurs from that may give you some unwanted attention. Imagine that those sort of interactions spread throughout a world that is also has a sort of cascading reactions on top of that. And you can get a sense of the different opportunities and the different challenges that may present.
One of the tools that we give the player is this sort of gluey ball that you get from certain plants in the underworld. So one of our playtesters found an application for this, trying to get past some of our traps. I had imagined one solution there where, you know, one thing you could do is just foul the trap by finding some monkey wrench to throw in the trap. Instead, she noticed the way the trap was seated in the world, right? There's a point where this trap is moving and there's a seam where it meets the stone floor. She lines up, hits exactly on that seam with the glue ball, and manages to glue the trap to the floor so that it cannot move. And then just, she waltzes by.
Players love to change everything in the world. It's called agency. So agency is my player's ability to affect things in the world. And so the more that we allow players to mess with the world, even if it looks kind of broken, I think that's great. I love it because it means that players have way more to do in that game.
One of the best things about the improvisation engine to me is the replayability. The idea that I can come back to a level and have a widely different experience with different quests, goals, different creatures that I'm fighting. Different creatures that are there that are potentially helpful.
You have the space in which to solve problems in ways that we might not have even foreseen. And we've seen this where people come up with solutions to challenges that, you know, we are surprised by. There's nothing we like better than to be surprised by the way that our players solve a problem that we've posed them.